Hovertech. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'm going to be showing how to extract public keys from a vbmeta image. So I've extracted my vb image from my firmware. Now for this tutorial, we're going to be using HXD hex editor. I'll simply drag the vbmeta onto HXD. So this is the interface. Now what I want to do now is I will scroll down a little bit. Now the first thing I'm looking for is a partition name. So here we have boot. Now we are going to copy out the items just after boot. So to do this, this is the end of boot. So I'm going to copy out from the hex section, that's the middle section. So I'm going to copy from here 00001000. I highlight and I scroll down until I get to the end, which is this one. You can see it, that the rest are all dots. Don't worry about this one, just stop at, just stop here. Now I'll right click, then copy, file, new. I'll paste the items I've copied, paste in setup, paste right, any of them is fine. So let me quickly create a new folder on my desktop. I'm going to call this keys, public keys. So I'm going to save this, save. I'm going to name it bootkey.pin. And save. Now we'll go over to vbmeta again. We need to do the same thing for system. This is where system stops. So I'm going to highlight everything just after system. And scroll down until the last item, which is this. Right click, copy. Save. We'll do the same thing for vendor, which is the next partition on the list. Now I'm going to be using shortcuts to create a new tab. Is Ctrl N, then Ctrl V to paste, Ctrl S to save. Vendor keys. Now we'll go over to product. Do the same thing for product. Notice I'm not bothered about this. I'm only stopping once I get the first line of zeros. Copy. Ctrl N, Ctrl V, Ctrl S. Close these items. I don't need them anymore. So I move on to recovery. Click on close. Yeah, one more time. Ctrl C to copy. Now an LDSP. Now this is GDSP. Highlights. Okay. So this is the end. Control C. For the next one is PM. SYS. That was a mistake. So I'm going to Control Z. PMSYS. So the next partition is DTB. Note that DTB ends here. There's a dot. So we start from here. Now DTB, we're going to scroll down. Okay, so now watch very closely for DTB partition, because DTB partition is the last partition. We need to look for this hex 0000110. That will be the end of DTB. So scrolling down. We found it right here. Can you see it? This is it. Now, alternatively, instead of going through all these items, we can simply come here. So, in front of DTB, we will do search find x value forward. X value will be 00. 000100, then okay. So it has found the first one, which is in front of the DTB. We need to find the end position, so we'll find again, and here you have it. Now we are going to copy everything from behind this, the four items. So we go backwards till we find DTB. So this is how you find the public key for the last partition. For me, my last partition is DTB. Yours might vary. Now I copy, new tab, save DTB. Now, for you to be sure that you copied everything correctly, let's quickly open one of the items we saved. This one, scroll down to the end. You can see the end says 408, DTB says 409. So I'm going to delete this to make it 408 and then save. So right here we have all our keys. You can delete this. This is an old backup. So that's how you extract public keys from a vbmeta image.